The SnapMaker 2 was a successful campaign and they raised a ton of money. I now have some ideas on my own on how to start my own company, but until then, let's just talk about the SnapMaker 2 and some ideas about it. I did not pledge anything yet. I felt that if I wanted a 3D printer, then I have to have it now rather than 8 months from now. But I did learn a few things in the process witnessing the SnapMaker 2. Today I'm going to share with you everything that you can find yourself on the SnapMaker 2 campaign and sprinkle some of my ideas on top of the facts. It seems that the SnapMaker had already planned to release new features or modules or machines, and those seem a bit more important and better designed and more sturdy than the actual SnapMaker 2, the A150, the A250, and the A350. I drew that conclusion because, as we can see from the website, they are all well made, cut to spec with CNC precision, but there is a difference in the way the XL CNC is made or designed compared with the SnapMaker 2, the 3-in-1 3D printer. I'm concerned about the sag. If there is a theory of relativity that everything moves in respective with everything else, in the same manner, sag seems to be a universal constant. So everything sags, especially with length. On the website, we can see that there are 3 products or upgrades which will be available for pre-order. The Rotary Tool, XL CNC, and the High Quality or High Power Laser. Furthermore, it does not specify if the XL CNC will cut metal. And that it was a main question on the forums and the groups. Will it cut metal or not? And I mean the SnapMaker 2, not the add-ons that they're planning to come out with at some time later. The XL CNC doesn't specify if it will cut or will not cut metal. By the size of it, it may be able to do some aluminum, but further than that, I will politely invite some of you CNC specialists to speculate on that, because I have no experience at CNCing and the tolerances. I wanted a lathe for the longest of times, but definitely no space for that. The issue also is that for metal CNCing, you need some oil. I would not trust to run those bits into any metal without oil. I think even for wood, when you push this machine at high RPMs, that bit will heat up like a volcano. So I'm just cautious on the promises or the speculations. But the website does not talk about the XL CNC being able to do aluminum. And in groups and forums, that question came up many times. So I will assume that the aluminum cannot be milled yet. The CNC will have a 700 watt spindle module. That seems quite powerful, but metal cutting is not mentioned. I'm not sure if in the marketing pictures that is a PCB board or some metal board that the spindle is drilling through. But one thing stands clearly out from the picture. The base of the XL CNC is reinforced on the bottom with 3 slot rails on the Y axis. Will it still sag on the X axis? I don't know. In addition, the side rails are only guides for the axis to travel. The frame seems to be made out of regular slot rails, which may make this a stronger frame. This makes me think that this may be the CNC most of us would like to have. But then again, the entire frame is on 4 prongs, so will the base sag in the middle of the x-axis? That remains to be determined. Now let me sprinkle some wishful thinking on this XL CNC. Could we buy the longer vertical Z axis and use it as a larger volume 3D printer? Now that's an idea there. So rather than having the bed move, it will have the entire X and Y axis or the gantry crane move on top of the bed, just like the CNC, but with the 3D printing head. How about them apples? Especially if this frame is third year and the software allows for bed leveling and mesh bed leveling. I mean, all the modules seem to be available and the software will be open sourced. So I think we can just buy the parts and snap make them together into a new SnapMaker, into a new SnapMaker 3, pun intended. And since I was so adamant about the top bar in between the Z axis, we can buy one of the slot rails and mount it there. And we just build ourselves a nice behemoth of a 3D printer, right? Let me know if you think this would be possible with all the snap modules we can buy. But in the meantime, let's just return back to reality and say that I would rather wait and buy the XL CNC after people have found a way to make that into a 3D printer. The current SnapMaker 2 comes with some cool 3D printing features, which I'm going to sprinkle some ideas on top of. Bed auto leveling, which we already discussed, that could be helpful if we convert the XL CNC into a large volume 3D printer. Filament runout recovery and upgraded cooling system. The filament runout recovery feature I find useful, and maybe in the future people would figure out a way how to create 3D prints in sessions. By pausing the printer and change the material, the filament, while the print is still on the bed, and then continue printing on the same 3D print with different material or different color. There were some instances where I could have used this feature. Print a portion of the model, then the printer stops for you to change the filament. You can do some extrusions just to clear the printing head and then resume the job with the second and or third filament. That is a software change, so it could be cheaper than hardware, multi-heads, and all the other stuff. And since this will be open sourced, maybe someone out there will make this feature available. But now, strictly speaking about the current SnapMaker 2, the 350, and maybe the 250, I will leave you to ponder some questions that have been rattling through my frontal lobe. The aluminum bed looks like all the other aluminum beds. Could it sag under its own weight and size? How about the base? Will it sag as well? Because there seems to be no reinforcement rails like in the XL CNC. One other concern of mine is how does the x-axis get synced? The left z-axis with the right z-axis. How do they sync? And do they ever get out of sync? And if they get out of sync, could the x-axis tug on the vertical rails, thus slightly bending them, thus affecting the assembly from being true? Could a connecting horizontal T or V-slot rail, which I talked about, connect the two z-axis and prevent the entire assembly bending under pressure? I would also like to see what's under the base of the SnapMaker 2, the A250 and the A350, because I think they may need some reinforcements, at least under the base. Well, thank you for watching. That was my rant.